you celebrate. I want to bring a very important thought for your life into the light. It is foundational to your well-being and wholeness as a person. So let's take a few minutes to hear God's Word. Think about the word celebrate and specifically what it is that you celebrate. There is a law of attraction and repulsion in place. What you celebrate and esteem comes to you. What you disrespect or disregard is repelled from you. This seems overly simplified, but it's absolutely true. When you think about this truth, you cannot help but review the question of what it is that you celebrate. Now, we're not talking about parties or occasions. This is about what you magnify and glorify in your life. Oh, that's easy. I magnify and glorify God. There was a time in my life when I would have quickly given that answer to anyone who asked me, but it wouldn't have been true. The reality of what you truly celebrate is found in the abundance of your words. Jesus said in Luke 6:45, "Out of the abundance of the heart, your mouth speaks." Think about that. All the things that you talk about and then consider what keeps showing up in your life. Understand this, what you talk about, share, inbox, text, and think on is what you're attracting to your life. If you talk about the problem, rehearse the problem, complain about the problems, magnify the problems, you are attracting bigger and worse problems. If you talk about the answer, magnify and glorify answers, you are attracting the answer. That's wisdom. In the book of Numbers, chapter 13 and 14, there are 12 men that go spy out a land God promised to his people. 10 come home saying, "Sure, it's a great place, but it's too much, it's too big, and the bad guys there are just gigantic. We can't do it. We look like little grasshoppers." They magnified and celebrated the enemy. They didn't mention God's power or his faithfulness once. They celebrated fear. They put themselves down. The other two spies were Joshua and Caleb. They basically rebuked the people and said, "Quit celebrating the strength of the enemy and celebrate the power of our big God. Let's take the land. It's ours. God is on our side." We call that faith talk. Often it takes courage and faith to celebrate the right things because we live in a world that is under a curse and hates God. The book of John 17 says that we, like Jesus, are in the world but not of the world. Celebrate answers. Magnify what's good, pure, and beautiful. Dedicate your mouth to magnifying what you actually want. Sing and shout about it. Let's put the law of spiritual attraction to work for us and not against us. Choose today what and whom you will celebrate. Now let's pray the word. Thank you, Father, for giving us your only begotten Son, Jesus. And thank you for giving us your word full of promises. Put a seal upon our mouth and help us to celebrate your grace, your salvation, your protection in the name of Christ. You haven't left us without great help, answers, or provision. Forgive us for talking and rehearsing the problems of the day over and over. Now, with your help, we set our minds on things above and choose to talk about your unfailing word. All in the name of Jesus. Amen. Listen, I want to thank you for spending this time with me. You're very important to me, and I want you to know that. Jesus died for you, and that makes you very important to the family of God. You can get more encouragement from Pam's and my podcast at lifetalkspodcast.com. It's free, it's fun, and full of encouragement. We love you.